Thank you, Dr. Namrata Goswami. My name is P.K. Gautam. I am a retired colonel of the Indian Army and I had fought in the 71 Bangladesh war and also I have experience in Siachen Glacier. I have been with the IDSF for the last 8 years and I have been researching for the last 15 years after my premature retirement. So I will now just in next 10 minutes in my research, I started first with non-traditional security, that is environmental security. And I found my one book is Military and the Environment. Because I had served all over India with every jawan and officer, I had served with Sikh troops, Jat Sikh, with Majwi Sikh light infantry troops, with all India mixed troops. I was OP officer with Gurkha Rifles, Jat regiment, the Indian, South Indian troops. So I had a very nice understanding of a great society. So that is the military and the environment. Agar aap log abhi Bhatti Main jayen Delhi mein ya Mussoorie jayen, if you go to Mussoorie, the complete Mussoorie has been developed by the ecological battalions of the Garhwal Rifle. So I did a field research. I went to Rajasthan, to Himachal, to Pithoragarh, and the military, the state government and the military are doing afforestation because environmental degradation, tanks and aircraft are no more the threat today for war. What is the threat is climate change, environmental degradation, deforestation. So from that perspective, I had did field work and then combined the research. So that is one book which is not on the web. This is not, you have to buy it. But others, all my research is freely available on the IDSA website in PDF format. So I'll talk of two books. Now, why? The first book was propelled on, it's a task force on Tibet and the Himalayan belt. So Professor Skoldam is from Ladakh and Namrata is from Assam. So there's a huge national integration. So I went to the Himalayan belt. And in my military time, the people were very good. I went again, they were the same. They were very happy and satisfied. So that propelled me to research on the Buddhism in the Himalayan belt. Buddhism, we know from Nalanda, was absorbed by Hinduism. But in our Himalayan belt, right from Jammu and Kashmir to Arunachal, there are Bhutias, there are people who practice Buddhism, Vajrayana. So when I did that research and I saw the refugees with the Dalai Lama and their universities, they had translated Indian Niti Sastra and Panchatantra and taken it to Tibet. So I said, what is this Indian Niti Sastra? Nobody had taught me. So there I started then researching, besides Tibet and importance as a society to preserve a civilization called Tibet, I said, if the Tibetan scholars from Nalanda was also took away Panchatantra and Niti Shastra, that means there was something to it. So here in India, I found there's a huge problem of Arth Shastra. Jawaharlal Nehru in his book Discovery of India has named Chanakya Puri. So I started trying to understand the Arth Shastra as a citizen of the world. And I found, lo and behold, it has got very good theory of political theory, better than Morgenthau. It has got management, better than Peter Drucker. It has got finance, it has got double accounting system, better than Adam Smith. And the Supreme Court, evidently, the lawyers swear by that book. Because if you throw litter on the ground, Arth Shastra, there's a punishment for throwing litter on the ground. So, and he talks of no religion. He is totally materialistic. He does not talk of any religion. So, that 100 years of Arth Shastra is my current work, because I found most of the European Indologists had initially translated into German or English. And India, because Sanskrit is a language which is not in use. So, and now the written tradition is also going. Children are not writing. They are typing on computers. So earlier, what you heard was the Panchatantra, which was made into stories, because there's a children's book festival here. So Panchatantra stories were basically to give you a moral lesson. So what can India or South Asia contribute to the world if Greek and Roman civilization, which were discovered only 200 years back, or in Renaissance, the complete little tiny, you know, Turkey and Greece, Thucydides, Socrates, if they could inform the complete Western philosophy, what can South Asia give to the world? It cannot give suicide bombing, riots. I mean, we can give to the world our indigenous historical knowledge right from the depth till today. And in my research, that is what, and I recommended that the Northeast is understudied. The Northeast is understudied. The South probably is well studied up to Chola. Later on, even you want to come to archives of Shivaji, Modi script nobody knows. There's only one 80-year-old professor who knows the Modi script. So you want to decipher the Peshwa archives in Pune Bakri. How do you research? It's not a novel. Research is you sit down on the text, on statecraft. So this book of mine also encourages that in a jobless society, if sponsorship is given, then we can get all our original work theoretically, and then we can use it as a text and have a parallel discourse with other post-colonial discourse which is developing in Europe. All your syllabus in universities, by the way, is Western oriented. Nothing wrong, because till 47 we were not in the, we were slaves. So was China. So when the rules of the UN, when the international laws were made, nothing was taken from Chinese or Indian civilization. So Indian civilization has got this fantastic, and we are multicultural. Just imagine, we have got multiple languages, we understand English, we understand our own culture, may not be that text, we are not very good. So that is in Kausalya's Arthashastra I found, and I am very happy and proud to be researching in a national institute. Only problem is now it is in English. Hindi na uska tarjuma, uska translation karna lazmi hai. Lekin mere South India ke students se jab main baat karta hu, kehte hain yaar Hindi mein kyun bol rahe hain, main to kuch nahi samajh rahe. So this is my, so therefore we are a very interesting society, and all your seven prakrits, that is a seven pillars of a state, Janapad, Kosha, Danda, is already given in Kautilya's Arthashastra. And there's no magic bullet. If you read Arthashastra, you will not become a superpower. Because there are three things in Arthashastra: power, Mantri Shakti, Prabhav Shakti, and your economic, your Prabhav Shakti, Mantri Shakti, and yeah. So according to Kautilya, Mantri Shakti is the best. But that means your economic and military should be there. So therefore we have to develop economically, and then you have good Mantri Shakti. And how a Janapad, a Rashtra, a concept of a nation already exists. See your note. There are 23 languages in a note. 23 languages in the note which you are carrying. So that is the challenge which we are trying to address, and it has just started. After Kautilya, we can do Kamandaka, come to the middle later, but the archives are not available. And maximum archives I found in Jain Somdev Suri's writing. Somdev Suri was a Jain, which are very non-violent, but his political discourse is par excellent. But his archives we are trying to locate. In Western University, some professors have got some data. So this is my contribution. So one book is on environmental security, which is in the stall, military and the environment. This on Kautilya and Tibet is freely available. There are other also publications by me, but I will not waste your time. Thank you for listening to Namrata and myself. I hand you over to